Yes, I am streaming them Megamins. They're like vitamins, only mega. I don't know. Anyway, what's going on, y'all? Welcome to Mega Man 10 Buster Only. We're at the end of the journey, as it were. Well, for this block, anyway. I still have a couple crossovers and other games to probably work through later on, and a bunch of spin-offs, but you can only get so much Mega Man in at a time. So, without any further ado, let's get to it. Go, Dolphin, go. What rock board game are you talking about? Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, no, Roll has caught the Roboenza. The most creative plot for a Mega Man game. Quick, rush, get her cowbell. Mega Man 10, solid game, terrible story promise. Although, given 2020 and this year, maybe it's not that. Wait, Dr. Wily's in Chinese. Ha! Yeah, they had tons of virus names they could have come up with, and they went with Roboenza. Like, come on, guys. This is the doofiest looking Mega Man face. Correct me if I'm wrong, but after Mega Man 6, shouldn't he be jailed? And correct me if I'm wrong, didn't Mega Man try to kill him in Mega Man 7? I'm talking to you with my back turned, because I'm that cool. Yeah, plotline literally doesn't matter. Let's go. Oh, they're like, Mega Man, jump, shoot, run. Proto Man reflects projectiles, can slide, and has a charge attack.
Who are you gonna play?
Can I not have... I thought there was a difficult version. No, whatever. Yeah, that's right. That's how you get to the shop. And this time it's you make the stuff out of the screws, you don't just buy it. I suppose I have a poll to make. 1 second. Chill, man. I actually have him in my reaction folder just in case somebody flies off the handle. It's the best. Just chill, man. All right. Josh wants to go commando. Anyone else? Nope. All right. We're going commando. The start of the game, salacious. Oh yeah, the music's amazing in this game. Although I've noticed Mega Man 10 actually plays a lot faster than Mega Man 9. Weeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee I always go that way. Let's go this way. Nope. No drops there. Oh. I think the silicone in my D-pad just broke. Yep, my right key's all mushy. Should be fine to should be fine, I'll just have to get used to it. The Mets. So do a lot of people. And I'm not talking the baseball team. Although Strike Man is sure a thing in this game. Fucking hell. Oh, that eventually goes away. Oops. Finally woke up. No, as it should. But also to stay true to the hardware, that you wouldn't have the sound to do it. Then again, that uses a noise channel, so it would actually take away the drums in the music. Ugh, you can't tell how far back you're being pushed. Get the favorable jump that time. Okay. Here's your health delivery. Never mind. Fucking nuts. Already drop? I'm gonna have to reset my router, aren't I? If I do, I'll just restart this entire stream just like it never happened. Because I've been dropping way too many frames lately. Once again, and with all my heart, fuck you, Rogers. Oh, now you wake up, you fuck ass. Ha 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 ha! I am so bad at this. Really, this level is just a combination of, like, the things I hate the most in Mega Man. Which is stuff jumping up from pits, Mets at the end of pits, and then... Yeah. Alright, so what does Commando Man do again? Because it's been a while. Ah. He's a stompy boy. Okay. Well, time to do this level over again, because I'm pretty sure that was my last life. Yep. This is semi-blind versus not blind Mega Man playing for me. Oh, I guess on the uptake you get a longer stream. Yay, slipping off of ledges! Although, considering I've made zero progress, if the stream starts chugging again, let me know and we'll just redo the entire thing. Because I might be victim to Rogers' technical ITMP or whatever bullshit they want to call it. That punishes me for using my internet. Just notice this is kind of offset. Hang on a sec. There we go. No more seam. I don't think. Yeah, if there is, I don't see it. Aha. found the screw cache. Only in Mega Man. Only in Mega Man. I found the screw cache under the sand. All night, Commando Man. When we go commando, that's all we do. You make it seem like I'm immune to stupid deaths, Josh. When in fact, the motto of the stream is ever snatching defeat from the jaws of victory. So, yeah. Kind of par for the course. Thanks. I must proceed at a high velocity. I must also get stepped on by that thing. A lot. Oh, I see. You can only do the stompy thing from, like, high up. Gotcha. Yeah, I was just figuring it out as AI. And now time to never use that. I love how they made the, like, spike-beaten Eddie calls cheaper. Hell, they made the half-damage thing cheaper. Thank you. So yeah, I don't need the load balancer at all. Okay, so that's Mr. Commando down. Pull this back up. Got one vote for the Blade Man. Anybody else? Nope. All right. Blade Man it is. Let it be on record that I hate those axe things. Also, the smaller, quicker spiders. Wait, what Power Rangers game? Wait, so you're telling me a game for the Sega Genesis has a design based off a game that released in 2010? That is not how time works. It's a homebrew? Then it's not the Power Rangers game for the Game Boy, for the Genesis now, is it? It's a homebrew. See, when you say these things without prefacing homebrew, I'm expecting official games. Or at least, games of their time. Well, because then you could say anything, like, oh yeah, how about that Ed, Edd n Eddy game for the Xbox 360? Like, what? There's never one. Yeah, well, it's homebrew. You see the confusion. One thing I love about Mega Man 10? Quick switching. What I don't love about Mega Man 10? That thing. I'm gonna have to meticulously make sure that I'm not jumping while that thing's momentum is going. Out of all the leg humpers in Mega Man, I never expected to add a jet-powered axe to that list. For a weapon tank, which I don't need. Blade Man, what you got? That's right, you stick to walls. Makes you nervous because of the spikes overhead. Meh, understandable. Pretty sure that's the point of it. Alright, just dive bomb me from there. Interesting. I don't know how to dodge that top one. It's really tough. Ah, shit. I got 5 E-tanks already, Jesus. Sorry, I'm not talking much. This requires a bit more concentration than I thought it would. And my concentration is already in short enough supply. Okay, I got it now. The top one just go in the opposite direction that he's facing. All right, two down. Where to next? Josh wants to chill, man. Anyone else? Nope, I guess the Josh Tatership runs supreme. Chill man it is. Second favorite track in Mega Man 10, this one. I'm not getting that one up. Tank. I'll be sure to use that never. Ass hat. Stupid guided missile dropping burbs. Stupid everything. Raw. I've been expertly debated. Well played, Mega Man. Thank you. Later, man. Bird gift change. All right. Now that one clashes with the overlay. There we go. All right, Chillman. Now that's a stun lock. Chill man has no chill. Guy's 10,000% aggro. I got a bunch of them, why not? Even with that E-Tank, I almost died. E is gonna be a pain during the refights. Chill man down. Where are we going now? Josh votes pump man. Anybody else? Nope. All right. Pump man it is. Dumb boss. Awesome stage. Though I do not care for the chonky oil mats. Shouldn't that theoretically allow me to float here, though? Oil floats on water. All Oops. I guess I'm not going that way. Ah, there's currents. I forgot about this part. That's just evil. Dive Man, time for you to join AEW where you belong. Right, I forgot that's this gimmick, you can shoot out these things. But like all barrier bosses, all he really does is just jump on you. Welp. He's annoying. All the barrier bosses are annoying. Except for Skull Man, he's a freaking joke. Nah, Woodman is Apex annoyance. Actually, no, Apex annoyance is the Mega Man 3 refight of Woodman. I got rushed yet. Oh no! The Robo Enza! But Dr. Light has made a prototype cure! Yay!
Well.
Dr. Wily is behind all this. Alright, that's Pump Man down. Pole is up. I'm just gonna run to the bathroom and be right back. I return. Looks like we're going to Solar Man. Also an awesome track. Oops. That's kind of the MO behind Rockman, you know? Miniboss! Fireburbs. Not wrong, can never have too much burb. I'd much rather deal with the flowers. Wait, did I even pick that thing up? No, I'm already maxed out. Well then. Thank you. Totally gotta beat Solar Man. Jesus, that does a lot of damage. Buster only doesn't seem to be the challenge it is when they're just when like they can't give me enough E-tanks. They literally can't. I'm already maxed out. Just because I used one. There. All right, Solar's down. Who's next? Strike Man. The only music I don't like in this game. Anyone else? Going once. Going twice. Sold to the only person who votes. Because it starts off really good, and then it goes into your standard baseball fight song, and it's so fucking corny. But of course, Japanese game, gotta have baseball. I'm honestly surprised it took him this many iterations to get it. See, like, this part's great. Yes, punch the sport ball. And then this happens. Well, Puckman is Pac-Man, so they can't do that. Thank you. Oh no, I got balls to my face. It's certainly creative. I'll give them that. Also the locker enemy. That one's cool. Like, I gotta say, as much as I shit on this being, like, baseball-themed and that being kind of dumb, they do really well, so... Yeah, eight's where you get the soccer ball. Christ, am I gonna have to use an E-tank on this guy? I don't know, maybe I can start here. Because God knows I ain't surviving this. Nope. You'd think a robot would be able to survive a soccer ball and back to the head, but, yep. Too close. I hate this mini boss. It's a cool design, but I hate him. Yay. I got one screen further, yay. Stupid ball. Stupid fist. Stupid mini boss. Blah. If I remember right, the mini bosses are harder than Strike Man. I was afraid of that. I need it at this point. So much for health drops, eh, game? Jesus. Well, again, as with most bosses, if you don't get hit by their body, you take significantly less damage. He's not really. I mean, he does like ball up bounce thing that Blizzard Man does. The only thing is the like ball that rebounds wherever the hell it wants to. Why follow a predictable set of physics, right? Just have it bounce wherever the fuck it wants. Like, look at that. Oh no. Thank you. I don't get this. They have the footballs following physics, as they would, yet they don't make the normal balls do that. I don't get it. Like, these ones do. I'm not fucking with this thing anymore. Thank you. All right, strike man down, two to go. Where are we going? Man, I want to save the best for last. Anybody got a countervote? Who am I kidding? Nobody else here but bots. All right, cheap man it is. Favorite music in the game. Also, favorite stage. Thank you. I don't need the weapons tank, so that can be ignored. Favorite level, favorite music, but easiest boss. Last but not least, Chonky Race Guy. Dang you, Uzi Joe. Damn you, Uzi Joe. Wasn't even paying attention to that. I forgot the trucks are insta-kill at this point. Okay, they're not insta-kill. Makes me want to play Cluster Truck again. But if I'm gonna do it, I need an audience of more than one. Unfortunately. a lot of those Twitch plays things, but with one person it doesn't really work. You don't know what cluster truck is? Go look it up. Seriously, go look it up. It is so good. To my life, son of a bitch. Yeah, essentially, Cluster Truck is a truck parkour game where your entire objective is to just jump on trucks that are, like, basically lol physics navigating their way through a level, and you have to get to the end of the level. I just got trucked. And there's a whole Twitch plays mode which adds like random modifiers based on what chat votes on. No, it's literally through the game. It's not through a channel point thing. It literally pops up in the game where we can both see, and it reads from my Twitch chat what people vote on. Yeah, Dead Cells does the same thing. There's a few games that do it. But Cluster Truck was one of the first. I don't know, maybe I'll play it on Rando Sunday. We'll do that. There we go, I finally got past that damn truck. Yep, 5 hours of sleep a night is not enough for me. Nah, the trucks aren't in Mega Maker. Or people would make incredibly obnoxious levels with them. I mean, they might add them in a future update. But I don't know how fast or slow the Mega Maker game is worked on. Mostly because the more I get exposed to the Mega Maker community, the least I want to be a part of it. The least, the less. What the actual fuck? Oh, that was a game over again? I'm gonna go have a smoke, then I'll try this again. Back in a minute. Alright, I'm back. What the hell's even up here? Something I can't access. Like, I've never gone up there. I'm glad I don't have a custom bot that can do sound macros. Oh, son of a bitch. Because knowing me, I torture myself by adding that as a sound macro. I'm figuring out how to program chatbots, though, so... Though that requires me to learn another programming language as well. Although, is Python a programming language or a scripting language? I don't know. I guess it's a programming language, because you can write something in Python, compile it, and have it run... on its own, so... That makes it a programming language. I just answered my own question. Although, wait, no, people call it a Python script and you need a Python runtime environment, so... But then that would consider Java a scripting language, not a programming language. I don't know. Thank you. Like, what the hell is this wheelie cluster fuck? It wouldn't be so bad if you could shoot through the wheels. Now, he's an absolute joke. It's just on Buster only he's hard. If not, you just use the chill spike, you pop his tire, he throws a hissy fit, and you just take him out. All the bosses in Mega Man 10 have the Mega Man X problem where they're like cripplingly weak to their weaknesses. It's not just like they take more damage, it literally knocks them off their game. He's really not. If I had save states, I'd show you that he's not. But this is Buster only. Roughest stage? Sure. Roughest boss? Hell no. That still goes to Captain Curveball. Thank you. It's funny because that sneeze implies that Wily's a robot. Roll's the best. How does Wily get the investment capital to build these crazy ass ships? Or ships, bases. Fuck, it's Woodman. It's Woodman! Gemini Man. Kind of acting like Gemini Man. Blackman. Ah, poop. Oh yeah, the real music. Guess I'm going left. It is rare in an actual Mega Man game that you go left. Thank you. Alright, which three is it now? Flame Man. Oh, if he's just gonna do that. Windman? No! No, wait, that's Napalm Man. They look very similar. Okay. So what are we doing first? Napalm. Ringu. What's not fair against these bosses is all of them I'd normally have charge. I just died to a pointer. Oh, that was close. We'll be right back. Oh, it stops and turns around. Okay. Last three. I honestly don't remember the Wily bosses, so... Slash Beast. No, wait, that's... I don't remember who the fuck that is. I don't remember who the fuck this is. Stupid Mega Man 8 and Mega Man 9 bosses. Tornado Man, I remember. Fucking really? I literally have no idea who those two are. Like, they seem like Mega Man X bosses, and yeah, no clue. It spiked me, Grundle! Oh, now I have 8 lives to screw around with. Could you imagine if that was all Leckman did? It'd be so easy. All right, I don't need that. Right? Yep. Seems I miss a bunch of hidden abilities here. Or it's for Proto Man. I don't know. It always turn them off of me. Well, basically on top of me. I was gonna say in the corner, but it really doesn't. Haven't beaten this game, but there's an easy mode. There's no excuse. You can beat it. Smashed what, your Wii? Because you shouldn't smash your Wii unless it's on camera, because there's money in that, apparently. I know, weirdos on the internet. Okay. I will not comment any further on that. Okay, let's go. Spawns him right on top of me. How is that fair? Oh, that is such a dick move. Ah, yes. Great music. I forgot the color-changing dudes are in this game. Fine. Burbs. Wasn't moving before. I assumed it wouldn't move. Thanks, game. See, this one doesn't move, and then, now all of a sudden it does. Nice pattern. Very easy to follow. I always fall victim to those. We'll be right back. Glad I'm terrible at dodging these fires. For gift change, all right. Actually don't understand it, like, at all. Definitely seems completely random. Nope, could have got a mystery tank. Oops. Meant to scroll the other way. Annoying when they keep changing rush jet rules every single game. Like how much he can steer up and down, if he can move back and forth or not. Isn't there? Wah. I guess one's supposed to use the thing as a platform. Oh. Son of a bitch. Oh, that is such a dick move. pick. All right, finally. Crab Puncher. He's a crabby boy, he's a punchy boy, he's a crab puncher. Impeccable defense. Oh, I can actually take out the claws. Okay. Those are some pro dodges. Actually, I have the lives. I'm just going to see if I can make it. Nope. Save as many as my E-tanks as I can for Wily and friends. Speaking of, there is a game on Steam called Fight Crab, and it's what you think it is. It's kind of a 3D brawler, but you're kaiju seafood. Oh, this track slaps too. Like I said, the only track I don't like on this OST is Baseball Man. Oh yeah, this thing. A lot of people in Mega Maker use this one. Well, I mean, it's one of the major features of a Mega Man game. Why wouldn't you talk about how the track slaps? Underwater version.
Go into the water. Live there. Die there.
I can't do Nathan Explosion. Only Brendan Small can do. I don't know how the fuck Brendan Small does so many goddamn voices. I wouldn't say he's Terra Strong levels of good, but he's up there. Dick. Sheesh. All right, what's next? The Room. Well, hi, Mark. Oh, never mind. It's the Block Devil.
Right.
Well, that's even more fucking confusing. So, don't stand on the purple. Stand on the pink. Can't wait for this one to take 8,000 years to assemble itself, too. Box. Oh, I can't even touch the fucking thing. This boss. Now I gotta go through the pain in the dick of trying to memorize how they unfold. Oh, great. What the fart? Well, that's new. Thank you. I feel no joy in beating that. The only joy I have is that I don't have to do it anymore. What the actual fuck? Okay, I'm going the other way. The other way had a one-up. Welcome to the refights. Solarman. A praiseworthy solar. Or something. Being extra douchey. I don't wish his attacks were better. I'm having enough trouble with them as is. Holy fuck. Dude, calm down with your RNG stomping on my face. I don't feel like annihilating a whole bunch of energy tanks on these bosses, but I might have to. Yeah, I just noticed. Yeah, Capcom is definitely taking the piss with this guy. Just, like, look at his pose when he jumps. He has a sun on his head, like... I was making a snide comment before, but it's just bloody obvious. I'm just gonna have to hope Wily is easy because I'm about to piss away all my E-tanks on these bosses. Say what you want about the early Mega Mans, but at least I could beat a bunch of them without dying. This boss is literally the only boss in Mega Man 10 I can beat without a fucking E-tank. Well, Buster only, anyway. Almost got him. Thank you. It's an old school arcade thing. You know, where running platformers couldn't really establish you taking damage from an attack every single time. And that wasn't me learning, that was just me getting lucky. The guy is so RNG. To jump directly on me, don't you? Ah, fuck. Well, that was close. Freeze you while you're in damage stun. Wow. That's some grade A dicketry. Thank you. Okay, don't come down then. I thought he was gonna jump. Didn't come down at all. Now that's silly. All right, Wally, what you got? A pirate ship. Kesko the fuck? I see. Oh, really? I guess I used the last E-tank for nothing. Yeah, this is where they took the piss out of this. But welcome back to the drills. Don't need a weapon tank, so it's fine. Real Wally, Robo Wally. Yeah, how do you cure the Robo-Enza? Oh, just put a bolt on some fucking pill caplet. That means it's for robots. Huzzah! And thus brings the Mega Man Buster only challenges to an end. Overall, I'd say I'm glad I did them, but I'm not going to attempt to do them again. Is good stuff. And since Mega Man's done, I just edited my schedule image, so now I can reveal what is next. Well, once the credits are done, anyway. So it took 3 hours for this one, but honestly, now that I'm practiced at it, I could probably do it in under two. Going on this credit scene. Like, you remember 9, where there was like an epilogue for every robot? Or like even 6 that had like statuses of robots and stuff? Kinda disappointing. Good credit music, though. Jesus Christ, how much credits do you have to go through? It's so long my virtual Wiimote disconnected. Yay. Oh, now I can play in hard mode. I sure as fuck ain't doing Buster only on hard mode. I knew there was a hard mode, though. Oh, well. I'm not going to attempt to do hard mode Buster only. I mean, I'm sure it can be done. Yeah. You see the difference. Yeah, no thanks.